This is Detective Rivera with the Orange County Sheriff's Office. Today's date is February 24th, 2010. The time is 4:16. In the room with me right now is a Thomas George Tobin. Is that correct?
Correct.
Did you see any blood in the water or anything like that?
Well, that's part of it. She was scalped, and there was no blood.
Okay.
So pretty much we knew then that the heart wasn't beating.
Once they were able to pull her away, how did he let go of the...
He didn't.
He never let go of the...
The arm?
The arm.
He swallowed it.
He swallowed it? So the arm is nowhere.
Right.
The situation with Don Brancho, it didn't just happen. It's not a singular event. You have to go back over 20 years to understand this.
Was a really exciting thing to do until everybody wanted to do it.
What were they telling you were going to do?
Capture orcas.
They had aircraft, they had spotters, they had speedboats, they had bombs they were throwing in the water. They were lighting their bombs with acetylene torches in their boats and throwing them as fast as they could to herd the whales into coves. But the orcas had been caught before, and they knew what was going on, and they knew their young ones would be taken from them. So the adults without young went east into a cul-de-sac, and the boats followed them, thinking they were all going that way, while the mothers with babies went north. But the capture teams had aircraft, and they have to come up for air eventually, and when they did, the capture teams alerted the boats and said, "Oh no, they're going north, the ones with babies." So the boats, the speedboats, caught them there and herded them in. And then they had fishing boats with seine nets that they would stretch across so none could leave, and then they could just pick out the young ones.
We are only after the little ones. And little ones, you know, a big animal still, but I was told because of shipping costs, that's why they only take the little ones.
They had the young ones that they wanted in the corrals, so they dropped the seine nets, and all the others could have left, but they stayed.
Where they're trying to get the young orca into stretcher, and the whole family is out here 25 yards away, maybe, in a big line, and they're communicating back and forth. Well, you understand then what you're doing, you know. I lost it. I mean, I started crying. I didn't stop working, but I just couldn't handle it. And just like kidnapping a little kid away from a mother. Everybody's watching, what can you do? It's the worst thing I can think of, you know? I can't think of anything worse than that. Now, this really sounds bad, but when the whole hunt was over, there were three dead whales in the net. And so they had Peter and Brian and I cut the whales open, fill them with rocks, put anchors on their tail, and sink them. Well, really, I didn't even think about it being illegal at that point. I thought it was a PR thing.
They were finally ejected from the state of Washington by a court order in 1976. It was SeaWorld by name that was told, do not come back to Washington to capture whales. Without missing a beat, they went from Washington to Iceland and began capturing there.
I've been part of a revolution and two change of presidents in Central and South America, and seen some things that it's hard to believe, but this is the worst thing that I've ever done. is hunt that whale.